Oh, and with a serve like that, he was immediately put on the defense, and Lin Wenru finds a way to sneak that out from the hip on the fourth ball. Good power here in a mid-rally serve. Gets Grote the point. See the players drying their hands between towel breaks, which come up every 6 points. And Wenru just checking his racket there. Hard top sheet. Well, tacky top sheet. Hard sponge on the forehand.
2-1.
This is much like the Chinese setup that you'll see. Generally, the forehand needs more spin. The backhand needs more spring because there's less motion on your backhand to generate racket speed. Perfect placement deep into the backhand as Grote pins Lin Wenru on the step around. There's the opening. When you bring in your opponent over the forehand side or middle of the table with the backhand, it's natural to go back deep into the backhand corner. Heavy spin from under the table, well protected. Grote playing that clever and smart. Again, when you're under the table, you're not easily going to be able to overpower your opponent, so make it awkward. Keep it uncomfortable. Forehand on the parallel, the step around. You can see Lin Wenru is going to have a lot of footwork cut out for him already. Grote playing some wise table tennis here. Forehand flick to start it off. Getting low and moves his weight forward. Czech Republic for me is when Lin Wenru really opened up the eyes of the world to his game, started taking down Chinese opponents. Then by T2 would silently beat Fan Zhendong and Ma Long. Beautiful net recovery here from Lin Wenru. Got a lot of little mannerisms that he likes to do, including sort of rolling the ball as if it were a baby hamster in his hand right before the serve, making a little squeak with his fingertips. There it is, a little squeak. Nice change of pace, slows it down a little bit. For a player who plays so aggressively with so much topspin, it's quite impressive that he's able to change his game. Change the timing like that mid-rally in an open rally. Good coverage, the counter down the middle. Lin Wenru accelerates forward, reaches out in front. Talked about timing, there's one. Extra speed and spin there. You could see more wrist on that last shot. This is something Grote would have prepared for time and time again. Classic Lin Wenru game. Open up with a strong backhand from baseline. In a two-point game, it did feel a little bit closer than it appeared for a moment. So clean. Grote deals with a lot of spin. This is the thing about the professional level. These pros, as long as you can recognize the spin, knowing how to deal with it, getting in position for it, angle of the racket closed, the flex in the quads here from Grote as he covers that and puts side and top spin on it for the win. That's big. Nice deep serve. Now, I was wondering about this. At the second towel break, Lin Wenru here has used his long serves incredibly effectively against right-handed players. Hadn't seen so much of it out here just yet, but a good deep serve into the body. This time has to be cross-court. Usually he's doing it down the line. This combination, it's not the first time we've seen Grote turn the corner. Handle a big, fast shot, come in. Gives a long push, says you go ahead and spin it. And then quick turn for the forehand win. Oh, he got it back. Groth on the chase, the taller of the two players. Makes a beautiful leap out to that wide forehand, forcing one more shot from Lin Yunru. That one right there, it's an awkward ball. Lin Yunru gets low and plays it right back into the middle of the table. Remember last time they played, Lin Yunru didn't drop a game. Oh, the under the table scoop. Underspin baby snake here. Take a look. Groth leaving no sign as to what's on that ball and the pressure to keep it low to the net. Can understand, especially with Groth's forehand waiting on the other side.
Seven, nine.
Constant game of cat and mouse here. Lin Yunru staying ahead as he dries, cleans the racket.
Seven, nine.
I guess moistens it up and then cleans it, lets it dry. Responsibility of the server to dry the ball before they serve. Right down the line, smothering shot, does not let it rise. Silent Assassin now with three game points. Quick parallel turn. Chiquita, follow up and it's gone.
10-8.
One game point saved, sends it to the third towel break. I saw exactly what you saw, so I'm with you. Half long, this is what it's all about. Barely comes off the back edge of the table and not enough room. Coach Iseki, as he was named in Japan. Lin Yunru back for game two.
One love.
A little bit of fortune and the Silent Assassin speaks English nonetheless, which he's quite good at. A little fun fact. His whole family speaks some English.
Two.
Now in the touch game, Lin Yunru very solid near the net. When you have a dangerous attack over the table and you're good in the touch game, it's tough to find answers. How to get into the open rally, how to get your opponent off balance, that's what Groth is going to be trying to do. And the quality in these two forehands, first one pinning Lin Yunru as he tries to step around. Watch him get held up there. And in that moment, he plays a more passive shot, which allows Groth the time to follow up aggressively, move back into the table, and take control.
Let one, two. Two, all.
Now, this is like serving a bottle challenge to a right-handed player because Lin Yunru favors that banana flick so much that he comes over to the wide forehand side for a backhand. Slow and spinny, one of my favorite shots in the game, partially because it's such an unsung hero. It's not glamorous. Push from behind the table, but well placed. And look how low that ball is by the time it reaches Lin Yunru. That is the effect of a slow, spinny shot in an open rally. Especially even if you're the opener, if your opponent is expecting a drive or some fast attack. Shallow, low, spinny. Long serve puts on the pressure. A bullying serve here as Lin Yunru ties it up. The surprise factor right to that baseline in the middle of the table, then on the hip, catching him in the crossover between the forehand and the backhand. We call it the middle, that transition point.
Four, three. Let it fall three. Fall all.
Beautiful placement here to level the playing field once again. Take a look at this rally. Out in front, the drive, parallel backhand, Lin Minru. After all, Groth has been playing a lot of forehand, so keeping him honest, giving him a reason to not feel comfortable to turn.
Five,
this is incredibly close. If the ball contacts Lin Minru while he's over the table, it's Groth's point. Very close, just barely backs up. Even if the ball was clearly going out, if he is above the plane of the table. It's one of the more interesting rules, but you can understand. Every sport has a few. Burned once again. Ah, the pain.
Left, four, six. Five, six.
Now, should Jonathan Groth lose 0-3 by 2 points every game, most people won't look into the details. You'll know, but he's looking to one-up that. He's looking to do one better. And by one better, I mean win this match. Relying on that backhand for me is going to be crucial. It's tough because you've got a player who's got such a wonderful backhand, who's so smooth. But at this high level of the game, Lin Minru will, well, punish you if you rely too much on stepping around, as we've seen. Dead even here at 6 points apiece.
Seven, six.
Fine balance again in the backhand to backhand battle. Lin Minru seems to be the more prepared. It's what you might expect. Good placement on this. Very short to that forehand side. So surprised to hear him speak. Trying to get a lip read there.
Seven, eight.
Impressive shot for me as Lin Minru falls back from the table, still manages to generate a quality shot to the baseline with positioning. I used the word bully earlier, and it was a similar tactic out here. Fast, long to rush the shot out of the opponent. Change of pace, big time, slows it down for one and sends in a flash of light for the next. There's the slow one, shallow on the table, comes in from under, and Lin Minru drives that ball so fast. You know it's coming in the replay, and still it seems untouchable. Kick serve, side and topspin. The shovel sets up 3 game points for Lin Minru.
Eight, ten.
Just like last game, Groth survives the first, saves 1 game point. It's funny, that hamster squeak that Lin Minru does drying the ball. It's one way to make sure you've got a very dry ball when you're serving, which is super important because if you miss the serve, that's on you. But if your opponent misses the receive because of a wet ball, they can show the umpire and it's a replay. Coverage, cell phone service by Lin Minru out here.
Lock one.
Not an easy serve to handle, but still Lin Minru finds a way right off the bounce to send it back with quality.
One, all.
Now in case you're curious, because I was, Anton Schellberry is waiting for the winner of this match. That's right, the Olympic silver medalist who beat Tomokazu Harimoto in the team's event to save Sweden. Sweden was incredible in Paris.
2-1.
That was the team's event, by the way, that silver medal. Him, Christian Carlsen, Truls Morgard as well. So as Groth dries his hand, And Minroo drives the ball.
One, three.
Still takes his chances here, a long way to backpedal. And Grote just saved his timeout, in my opinion. Had Lin Minroo won this point, we'd likely be seeing that timeout. Here's the chase, a bit more passive, good combination from Grote. All backhand, only the first one comfortable.
Three, all.
Leveled out at the first towel break. Grote fighting for survival in a must-win game. Again, for Grote to advance, one, he'd have to win this game and the two to follow. Two, he would get six times the ranking points. That's a big deal. This level of play, again, just to be here is extra credit. Most players in the world don't qualify to be here, only the best.
All three.
The push, push, rally. It's a game of hot potato and a little bit off the top of the net. A little fortune for Lin Minroo. There it is, ball slows down a bit, changes the timing.
Let ball three.
Long serve finds the edge. Little bit of top and side spin, some good pace, and that ball kicks. Even at the professional level, that extra top side spin really has its effect.
Three, six.
I say that because at local clubs, you'll meet uncles and players that say, are you ready? Short game, touch, touch, take your time. Quality rally out of the timeout. It really takes some critical thought. You look at your opponent, you say, what areas, even if 9 out of 10 skill sets, he would beat me, what's the one where I would beat him? How do I get him to play that with me? Pound for pound, Jonathan Grote, the bigger guy, no doubt about it. They'd be in different weight classes if this were wrestling, boxing, or contact.
Six, five.
This is one of the beauties about table tennis. You don't have to be 7 feet tall or 100 kilos to play. As a matter of fact, it might not help if you were. I know I mixed it up there with, what did I say, feet and kilos? Anyway.
Five, seven.
The reason I bring it up is it's a game of speed and spin. And it's a game of brains as well. Outthinking your opponent, being clever. Your problem solving, it's a puzzle in real time that's physically demanding. So how can Grote find ways to slow down Lin Minroo, who's light and fast?
Bet, five, seven.
And again, when you take your chances, the quality of the opening is key. Oh, back edge of the table.
Six,
little
seven.
Snake from underneath, and it bites just the very edge for a point.
Wow.
Tough to win it from down there. A little fortune, though. Oh, this is a way. Second time in a row we've seen him serve from the middle of the table with what appears to be a pendulum serve deep to that forehand side of the table, and then Lin Minroo moves around for the Chiquita. It's bait. Takes it right off the hook and leaves open the backhand corner. Not a bad answer. It's just going to come down to real specific placement when he plays that Chiquita. I love it. He does the same thing back. Lin Minroo says, nice plan. I'm going to try it on you, see how you like it. Serves from the middle of the table, pendulum. Very similar placement and gets right into the rally. Short stroke for the angle there. And now he's got the full stroke to finish. Half long, as half long as can be. The whole idea is he's wanting to play and not delay. The whole idea is to cause some indecision on the other side. Second bounce once again, heavy backspin as the ball comes back towards the net. A ghost push, if you will, and it is 3 match points for the Silent Assassin. Look at that. Ball with the mind of its own.
Seven, ten.
Return to sender. 7 serving 10.
10-8.
Every single game it's been 10-7, and the next point has been won by Groth as he clips the net here with a strong backhand opening on the parallel. Out of the third towel break. Will the pattern change? Serve like game one with Lin Min Ru. Wasai, what a rally to finish on Lin Min Ru.